Unleash your curiosity as you step into the exhilarating world of the 2024 Cupra Formentor, a SUV that blends style and performance seamlessly. With its dynamic design and powerful engine options, the Formentor beckons you to explore a driving experience beyond the ordinary. Are you ready to redefine your journey with the sporty elegance of the 2024 Cupra Formentor? This is the 2024 Formentor SUV from Cupra. That doesn't really clear anything up, does it? Well, Cupra is a sporty, standalone brand spun off seat, having previously been the mere performance arm of its Spanish parent. Confused? There's more. Cupra will shortly become the main mass market sporty brand for the entire Volkswagen group, with seat tucking in behind as a sort of mobility thing. Anyway, the Formentor is the first unique model from Cupra, so you won't be able to peg the car straight off as an awkwardly rebadged family runabout. It's a mildly confusing little car. It's an SUV, because those are fashionable and people want a high-riding slice of comfort and security. Except it's a hunkered-down, low-running SUV because people always want something that's a bit dynamic. The Formentor engine selection isn't quite as spicy as you'd think from all the racy advertising. The range starts off with a 148 brake horsepower 1.5-liter four-cylinder that's familiar from other VW products, and manages the 0 to 62 miles per hour sprint in a glacial 8.7 seconds. Next up, there's a 2.0-liter unit developing 187 brake horsepower that knocks nearly 2 seconds off the 62 miles per hour dash. If you're feeling vaguely eco-conscious, there's a plug-in hybrid setup in two states of tune, teaming a 1.4-liter turbo engine with an electric motor to develop either 201 brake horsepower or 242 brake horsepower, 7.8 and 7.0s. If you're feeling less eco-conscious, the range topper is a 306 brake horsepower 2.0-liter four-cylinder turbo unit driving all four wheels and familiar from the likes of the VW Golf R and Audi S3. That manages the 0 to 62 miles per hour run in 4.9 seconds. There are 6 trims available. V1 and V2 are the starter course, VZ1, VZ2 and VZ3 trims the tasty main, and then there's the cherry for dessert, the VZN model. The car now starts at just over £31,000 for the V1, ranging to a slightly eye-watering £48,270 for the 306 brake horsepower VZN. That's quite some ground to cover. The PHEV, or e-hybrid as Cupra calls it, offers up to 36 miles of official range and a 3-digit fuel economy figure. Both will be significantly less in practice, but the car's 12% BIK rating make it the default option for company car buyers here. The entry 1.5-liter petrol will sip along at around 40 miles per gallon, while the spicier petrols are rather closer to 30 miles per gallon. The Formentor is not exactly a car of many surprises. It's built on a tried and tested platform. It's powered by engines that be shown in many a decent, recent hot hatchback. But that's not to say this curiously badged, go-faster offshoot is an also-ran. Seats Ateca is one of Top Gear's favorite crossovers because it's so willfully unpretentious and easy to use, yet the driving experience manages not to be the motoring equivalent of a third-division 0-0 draw. It's almost fun. So, taking those ingredients and wrapping them up with more power, in a lower, prettier package creates a car that has some genuine appeal. And it doesn't matter that it's not a household name. Very few cars these days say anything about you beyond, "There was cheap finance available on this and I liked the color." Drive a Formentor and at least it says you might know a bit about cars beyond Google's first results page.